Well, odds are you've received one of those Nigerian fortune emails before and you recognize that it's a scam. Other cyber thieves use viruses to track what you're doing, and all they need is a little bit of info and information you leave on sites like Facebook, your hometown, or your zip code, so they can crack security questions on accounts. WMUR's Adam Harding tells us about the newer battles to keep thieves from breaching your security.
Once you put it on there, it's out there for anyone to get access to.
For years, it's been the target of these so-called cyber crooks, your personal information compromised, and oftentimes your finances ruined.
I think it's getting easier, and the ability of people to hack into computers apparently is getting better. So people are more vulnerable to that kind of attack.
Jim Buffetti leads the consumer division of the state attorney general's office. You could say his office acts as New Hampshire's consumer watchdog.
We get a lot of complaints about people whose debit cards or credit cards were misused. We get indications sometimes of people who had their social security number stolen. People will find that accounts were opened up in their name.
And a lot of that information, personal information, is stolen off the computer. Websites you think are secure only to find out they're not. People can also fall victim without doing a thing. Companies, employers, places that hold your information, they've had hard drives stolen, security breached, and information lifted.
Information tips on a whole range of things.
The AG's office keeps track of those security breaches on its website. It's all part of a state law. In 2008, they received 184 security breach notifications. In 2009, 104. And last year, 96.
Is that a sign that people are taking better precautions?
Well, I hope so. I hope that, you know, we've certainly done our part, I think, to try and get the word out and to notify people of the scam of the month, if you will.
And they're not alone. The Consumer Sentinel Network is an online database tracking millions of complaints received by the FTC and Better Business Bureaus, among others. In 2009, more than half the complaints filed were fraud and more than 20% ID theft.
Identity theft in the computer is a huge problem in this country.
Scott Valcour is the director of project management and consulting services at UNH. He says the internet is littered with high-tech thieves mining the web for your personal information, names, addresses, birthdays, anything. They'll scour Facebook, MySpace, and try to pass off your identity, your emails, as their own. It's called social engineering.
The social engineering exploits that are being used are oftentimes coming from foreign countries as well as within our own country to unsuspecting users, you and I, that they find pools and pools of email addresses and names that they can send to.
Computer experts can build viruses and send them through those email lists. To the untrained eye, it certainly looks legitimate. But all it takes is one click for your computer to be infected, and some viruses called keyloggers track your every move.
Whatever key was pressed, it will have that recorded, and that becomes another source where the malicious folks out there can steal information.
And that information can be bought, sold, moved. It's more a global issue.
How do we prosecute somebody who we don't know who it is?
Right. You can't. The simple answer is you can't.
That's why it's important you take steps to protect yourself. Before putting in credit card information online, look for HTTPS in the address. The S stands for secure. Bank statements, you should always check those, and once a year check your credit score. As for those emails asking for your information, it should be you asking the questions and making the calls. The bottom line, it's a problem that isn't going away until you push it out. I'm Adam Harding for WMUR News 9.
The AG's office says debit cards are more problematic than credit cards with ID theft. Credit cards typically have fraud protection. So if you do fall victim, call the credit reporting agency, the credit card company considering canceling the card, and call the attorney general and local police and that website we mentioned that tracks security breaches. So go to doj.nh.gov/consumer and look for security breach notifications on the right side of the page.